Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. Sir, it is now more than 6 weeks since the finance bill was presented to the House along with the budget for 2004-5 government policies as reflected in these proposals have been very fully discussed in both houses of parliament. In my reply to the general debate, I had explained the broad economic and social objectives of the tax proposals. Elucidations of the detailed implications of these proposals have also been furnished to honorable members. I would in particular draw attention to the document rationale of the tax proposals circulated a few days ago, which relates to the basic economic objectives with the specific tax measures in the finance bill. It is not therefore necessary for me now to go again into the economic basis of the budget. The tax proposals have evoked a considerable amount of active and well-informed interest and perhaps also active resistance among certain sections, not only in this house but also outside in the press and among the public at large. Some of the interests concerned have made specific representations to government. This wide discussion that has taken place has been very useful and has helped us to formulate certain amendments to streamline the proposals in the finance bill to give a measure of relief where it was deserving and to remove some unintended hardships and anomalies. The official amendments that have been tabled are as a result of this process. I place them before the House in the hope that the provisions of the finance bill as modified by these amendments will serve to implement more effectively the basic objectives of the budget, namely growth with social justice, and I shall confine my remarks in the main to explaining how the amendments proposed fit into the overall rationale of the provisions in the finance will. Sir, at the time of introducing the budget, I gave some thought whether it was necessary for me to introduce the finance will as it relate to direct taxes at the same time, and whether I should not follow the practice followed in the United Kingdom of introducing a will later on after outlining the provisions. Finally, I stuck to the convention, but in the light of my experience this year, I do hope to be able to make the departure, namely to announce the proposals first and bring in the will later. Full stop.